In the last lesson, we successfully connected our Sanity application to this Nuxt frontend and we displayed our products. Something that we missed out on in the last lesson is to properly tell Sanity where our frontend will be reaching out from. And that is done in the Sanity dashboard right here. Since our Nuxt application is running on port 3000, we should add it as a recognized origin in our Sanity application so we don't face any cause errors in the future when we make requests to Sanity. So click into the project, go to settings, go to API, click on add a new origin and add the origin where your front end is connecting from. In my case, it is on port 3000 and do that. And now we are all set. So in this lesson, we'll make this product listing page look a bit better than this and also implement dynamic routes for individual product views, so that when you click on any of these products, you'll go to a unique route where you can find more information about the said product. So to get started, let's go back to Visual Studio Code. Here, we just have a template section and a script section that sends our request to Sanity. Next, let's update our Sanity query to specify exactly what properties we want to fetch from our Sanity products. At the moment, we are fetching all properties of the product. We can go ahead and be more specific about the details we want by specifying them here. So we want the title, and we want the slug, and we want the product ID, and we want the price. And we'll get that from default product variant dot price. If this looks a bit confusing, let me show you why I'm doing that. Back in Sanity Studio, if you run the query to fetch all products, you'll see that it returns an object called default product variant where the price is, also the images as well, but we'll get to that. Actually, let me copy this just to be sure that I didn't make any mistake with the spelling. Okay, and the next thing we need is the product image, and let's call it image URL. And we also get that from the default product variant object, and let's do dot images. This is an array, so we'll select the first image and get the image URL. And the last thing we need is the blob, which we'll get from blob dot en. And this is what our product query is going to look like now. With the styles and the script section done, the next thing we want to do is update the template. So I found a very nice template on W3Schools, I think, for product listing somewhere online, and I really liked it. So I'm just going to use it here and save us all some valuable time of typing it all out. So I'll just go ahead and grab it and paste it here. So basically I have some headings and some paragraphs, and in this div, I'm showing the product title here, I'm showing the blob, and then in this content block, I'm showing the product image. And down here, I have a link which you can click on to go into the individual product page, and we're doing that with Nuxt link. So if I save this, if I have done everything right, we should now get a better looking, okay. This is wrong. Let me do blob. I don't spot any more errors. So if we come back here and refresh this page, now we are getting a much better looking product listing page. However, if you click on any of the products, you get a 404. And that is because in our Nuxt link, we passed in the route, which is our product slug. And that is what you can see here. However, there is no existing page for this dynamic route in our application. So to change that, let's go back to VS Code, and inside the pages directory, we'll create a new file. Let's call it underscore slug.view. And the first thing we want to do is write a query that will basically use this slug and make a request to Sanity to fetch this particular product so that we can display it on this page. So let's just copy the existing query and modify it a little bit. So we get this script and we put it here. And what we want to do is pass in params here. And this will give us access to this log that we have in the URL. Now, instead of making a query for the product alone, we can modify this query to make sure that we are querying for not just the product, but also the one that matches the slug that we passed in. And that is slug.current equals params.slug. And this way we are making a request to Sanity to fetch this product where the slug is the one we passed in from the index page. The one we passed in from here. And that is the one that we have on this link. So great, this will return an array. So we'll probably want to just get the first one. Awesome. Once again, I have the styles for this. So I'm just going to paste it in here to save us all valuable time. And I'll go ahead and also grab a template for this and put this here. So let's do a quick walkthrough. We are showing the product image, which is coming from our query. This should be product, not products, which is coming from here. We're showing the image here and we're showing the product title and we're showing the price. And this is just a bunch of lorem ipsum for product description. These are just dummy data for quantity and two buttons to add to cart and to buy now. So if we save this and come back, there you go. Now we have individual product pages in our application. And this is also as far as we go in this lesson. In the next lesson, we'll go ahead and deploy our front-end Nuxt application and also our Sanity application so that both of them can be accessible from anywhere in the world. See you there.